I see, nasema karibu sana. Welcome, welcome to Celeb Corner KE. Now, in the field of politics, tumekuwa tukijua ya kwamba there is a certain thing that is currently happening in the country, ambapo the conversation has been about the impeachment of Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua. Now, a lot of people based the case of Rigathi Gachagua on a person of a data of President William Ruto against the DP, who has been trying to undermine the authority of the President of the Republic of Kenya. Now, this is not far from the truth, according to the latest report and the latest leak from the members of National Assembly, who are right now drafting the charge sheet against Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua and the motion of impeachment that will be tabled in the House and in the National Assembly come next week on Tuesday. Wengi wamekuwa wakisema kwamba Gachagua is going to be impeached on the basis of him being involved in the funding of the demonstrations of Gen Z, which happened on July and on June of this year. But that can be brushed away. That is an allegation that can be kicked out of any High Court or even the judiciary. Because if they try to bring in the evidence against the DP, if the bodies that will be hired by the Deputy President had to do the due diligence to try and find out how Gachagua hired the Gen Z, yet the Gen Z went ahead to protest without any help. They started their conversation on social media and then took to the street. It will come to be determined that the Gen Z did not have anybody hiring them. But what they are saying in regards to their file is that the DP hired bandits. Ndiyo waingia wapi? Wa infiltrate the Gen Z movement. Now, putting that aside, some new allegations have come to light. According to a report that has been published by The Nation this evening, is that Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua is blamed of undermining and even wanting to slap the President of the Republic of Kenya, President William Ruto, who is Gachagua's boss. In this allegation that has been tabled, it is believed that Gachagua held a meeting where in the said meeting, one person was present, and that is the PA to President William Ruto, Bwana Farouk Kibet. And a statement that was delivered today by Farouk Kibet in a certain gathering in the Rift Valley region proved what these allegations are saying. Now, in the corridors of power in our Republic of Kenya, if there is a man that is respected and given the higher authority in the State House and the President William Ruto's regime, is none other than Farouk Kibet. It is said that not even the wife of the president has a say over what Farouk Kibet decides to be done in this government. He is a man that is feared in the corridors of power in the Republic of Kenya. Yani, you can't access any tender in the government of the Republic of Kenya without the approval of this man. This man has to oversee everything around the president. And the reason why President William Ruto trusts Farouk Kibet so much is because back since their relationship dates back to here 1997, when Ruto started his campaign to seek the Eldoret North parliamentary seat. And since then, the both of them have never parted ways. They have been together. And this man is said to be the man, he is the bogeyman of President William Ruto. He has been the bogeyman of Ruto all along, protecting Ruto, making sure that any allegations that is put against him is currently, it goes ahead to be swept under the rug. Now let's get back to the meeting that happened between the Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua and President William Ruto. In the said meeting, because the tension had risen and the president had seen as if Gachagua was undermining his leadership, he went ahead to ask Gachagua what he wanted, and Gachagua told him, according to them, Gachagua told him that if you want me to resign as the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya, go ahead and give me 8 billion Kenyan shillings. Yeah, wire me 8 billion and I will step down from the Deputy Presidency seat and I will exit the corridors of power and go rest with my family and continue doing my businesses as I used to do, which the president is said to have disagreed with Gachagua and denied to give him the said amount of money which prompted the deputy president to bang the table for President William Ruto and even threaten President William Ruto. If it's not that Ruto is protected and that he is the president of Kenya, Gachagua even threatened to slap the president, according to the news that you are receiving. So according to these drafted charges, these charges, by the way, they are not just your mere allegations. According to the latest report and the insights that we have, these allegations have been put in the said impeachment motion. Ya kwamba uliitisha bribe from the president ya 8 billion ndio uweze kuresign kutokea katika kiti cha deputy president. And this, you know, Ruto has not spoken about Gachagua's nini vendetta against him. But if you look closely, let me tell you, once Farouk Kibet speaks, it's the president that is speaking. Now, Farouk Kibet spoke today, which tells you that he has endorsed, the president has already endorsed the impeachment of Rigathi Gachagua. And I want you to listen closely to the ones that came from this man's mouth. And we get to discuss Farouk Kibet and Gashagwa's relationship in all of this.
Bei ya ukabila,
sikiza na usikize kwa makini.
Tunataka bei ya mahindi iweze kuimarika, bei ya chai, bei ya sukari, bei ya kila kitu ya kumsaidia mwananchi hawe juu, ndio iwe bei sawa sawa. Bei ya ukabila ni mbegu ambaye baba askofu mnafaa kuchitokeza mapema na kulaani.
Mm-hmm.
Mimi nashukuru ile muungano ya wakubwa ya Catholic. Wakati karama ikienda juu wanakutana mara moja na kusema serikali haifanyi vizuri.
Now, that is Farouk Kibet that is speaking. And that Kenya should be a tribeless country. Unanielewa? Huyu jamaa akiongea kama jinsi ambavyo nimesema. It's the president that has spoken. Once Farouk Kibet speaks, his message is or can be compared to that of the president of the Republic of Kenya, President William Ruto. Kwa sababu, he is the insider inside the government of President William Ruto, and Ruto goes with anything that Farouk Kibet says. Which means, Farouk amesema Gachagua kwenda nyumbani due to his mulima narrative. Indeed, he has even dared Gachagua and told him, if you think that you know what, you have the following and you are a leader, you can sell out your tribal politics to everybody, then come to Nairobi and vie for the governorship seat. Tuone kama utakipata hicho kiti. Remembering that the Nairobi governor is Honorable Johnson Sakaja, who lately they had an altercation with DP Rigathi Gachagua on social media. Tunaelewana? Now, apart from these charges za Gachagua kuweza kuambilika kwamba ameweza aliweza ku threaten the president, should I remind you, by the way, Gachagua, Ruto chose Gachagua, alim select out of that disguise ya kwamba this man won't be an addict to me, he is a nobody, he is a one time member of parliament. Tunaelewana? Ni mtu ambaye influence yake iko down sana. So if this man, I select him, I know that this man is not going to be a threat to my administration, even in if anything happens uko in the future. But that is where he made a mistake. You don't pick somebody that has been in the force and expect them ya kwamba utawatumia venye unataka. Should I remind you that Gachagua is a trained paramilitary? Yeah. He's a military police officer. He is retired, but he worked as a military police officer. So huyu msee ni msee ambaye hajazoea kupewa orders za kijinga. He is somebody that worked direct with President Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi, became a PA to the former President Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta for so many years before leaving the PA position and going ahead to seek the seat for the Member of Parliament of Madhira. Tunaelewana? Now, Ruto has started realizing. Alafu, you know, Gachagua is a man that is also, he sees what is happening in the government. And una jinsi Ruto ana facilitate deals ambazo zinamnufaisha yeye. So Gachagua goes ahead also to facilitate deals that will benefit him. Now, according to the charge sheet, kulingana na kile ambacho tunakipokea, is that Gachagua went ahead kusimamisha a certain road that was being constructed in the coastal region, ambapo alifukuza the people that were constructing the road, alafu he gave the tender to one of his companies. Yeah, the tender worth millions and millions of money, akaipatiana kwa one of his companies. Na hiyo kampuni, ndio inaendelea na kadarasi ya kujenga hiyo barabara. Now, not only that, according to the information in the said charge sheet or the said motion of impeachment, Gachagua is also said to have accumulated excess wealth of about 5.7 billion Kenyan shillings in less than 2 years that he has been in power. So they are asking, how can you be able to have just garnered 5.7 billion Kenyan shillings katika utajiri wako, yet you as the deputy president of Kenya only receives a salary of about 12 million a month? Tunaelewana? So those are some of the allegations that are being laid against him. But let me ask you, you know, you are saying that Gachagua may accumulate 5.7 billion. Should I ask you, if we were to dig deep, huyu president wenu anaweza kuwa ni ngapi ameweza kuingisha? You know, he might be times 100 of that. Yeah, times 100. And when I say times 100, that is about 500 billion Kenyan shillings. Na inaweza kuwa hata imefikia ati. Yeah, so these MPs, you know, they have a vendetta, they have a bone to chew. That is why, you know, the president has kept quiet on this. The motion will be tabled next week. Remember, Rais alifika Kenya leo, coming from the United States of America, where he has been. But also, he is planning to leave the country on Monday, anaenda Congo. The country is, the president will be leaving on Monday to go to Congo. So when the motion of impeachment will be tabled, remember, Rais wa Kenya atakuwa nchini. So President William Ruto has jumped every loophole to associate himself with the impeachment motion. But truth be told, once a man like Farouk Kibet speaks, wadau, the president has spoken. Let me tell you, you can't mess with ikama kuna mtu anaogopwa katika hii serikali. Wadau. Hey, new Sema Nicholas Biwott during the Moise era, the total man. You speak about him as a bogeyman under the late president Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi's era. Muna muongeleanga tu hivi, jinsi ambavyo alikuwa mbaya, jinsi ambavyo he was feared in the corridors of power, jinsi ambavyo alifanya people like Koinange, I think people like JM Kariuki and others disappeared in thin air. Yo, you haven't met this guy. And for Biwott and Moi, that was a relationship that was just formed through Moi's kuweza kufacilitate huyu jamaa kwenda kusoma na kumsaidia akamaliza shule. So wakati Moi alikuwa naangalia akapatana na jina ya Biwott, ndiye aliweza kumwappoint na Biwott started growing through the administration to becoming what he became and becoming one of the greatest, one of the most feared cabinet secretaries during Moi's era, and also one of the most successful businessmen and politicians to have ever graced our land. That is the Republic of Kenya. When it comes to Farouk Kibet and President William Ruto's relationship, our watu walitoana kwa mashida pamoja. These people, the both of them, walianza pamoja in the 1992 Young Youth for KANU. So hapo ndio walianza kuform relationship yao. And it is believed that in 1997, Farouk Kibet is the one that pushed William Ruto to vie for the Eldoret North parliamentary seat, knowing that the candidate that Ruto was vying against alikuwa ni mse mwingine mnoma sana, and he had the resources, the money and all that. Even Moi didn't believe Ruto will win. But through the help and the strategies of Farouk Kibet, Ruto won that seat until he left the seat in the year 2013, ambapo he started vying he joined hands with Mr. Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta to vie for the presidency. All along kutoka 1992, Ruto amekuwa akisikiza Farouk Kibet, and amekuwa akimsikiza, and they have been successful together. Tunaelewana? That man akikuangalia hivi macho yake inakuambianga who he is. Is a man, he, just a stare from Farouk Kibet scares the shit out of you. If you try to make a move again as the president, let me tell you, even the wife to the president, awezi jaribu kuongea Farouk Kibet akiongea. And Ruto has always made that known to his family. And that man protects the assets of the family. And he anainshuanga yo, nini biashara zako, in any way zinaeza haribia baba yako jina, apana, zinaeza muharibia, so, hii biashara achana nao. That's what Farouk Kibet is. Na sasa, amesema, Gachagua shika barabara ya kwenda nyumbani. I tell you, I don't know what can save Gachagua. But let me remind you, Gachagua si mtu wa kufukuzwa, kufukuzwa na kugonga gongwa na vidole. That man is also a beast. I did a story about the 1992 clashes. Angalia utajua. Subscribe into our YouTube channel for more news and more updates on whatever is going on in the country. Yeah, sisi ndio tunakupasha, and we make sure that we tell you how it is. Sisi hatufichangi, by the way. Yeah, we tell you how it is. It's about you to make your decisions. That's it for now. Subscribe.